standing at the head of the serpent. Many of us don't like to speak of the devil. For some, the idea that there is an evil force at play in the world is terrifying. For others, it is easier to rationalize evil, simple, as the product of bad human choices. Others say that evil is man-made and there is no supernatural presence of evil in our world. But evil does exist. Good also exists, and God is good. The Bible often describes the war between good and evil as an epic heavenly battle. In Revelations, evil is represented by the seven-headed dragon that wants to eat the child, Jesus, as soon as he's born. This passage is not meant to be frightening. It is one of reassurance and hope. Good is victorious over evil. God sends his angels to protect the child, and the woman can escape safely. The battle that ensues results in Satan and his angels being cast out of heaven.
This is our hope. Good has already conquered evil. Christ has forever won us for God. More than that, Jesus has given us his mother to help us conquer evil and the temptations we encounter in our lives. She's the one who stands on the head of the serpent. One of Mary's titles is that of Immaculata, the one who was born without original sin. It is her purity of mind and heart that allows her to conquer the devil. Father Kentenich writes, "Once again, the image of the Immaculata appears before us. With a slight movement, she crushes the head, the devil's head. That is also our task. We too should help to overcome inwardly the devil's influence." Let us pray. O Immaculate Virgin, help me to recognize the influence of the devil in my life, and grant me the courage to reject evil in all its forms. When I am weak, stand with me as my shield and help me to conquer the temptations that threaten to overwhelm me. Amen.